Hi, this is Ward Becker, and welcome to another Loki video. Today, I'll show you how to use Promptil, Fluentd, and Fluentbit agents to ship logs to Loki. Promptil is the agent that comes with Loki. It's written in Go, and is typically deployed as a daemon set on your Kubernetes clusters. For today, we'll keep it simple and run the Promptil binary with minimal configuration from our laptop. Let's browse to github.com and search for the Loki project. On the releases page, we'll copy the URL of the latest Promptil release. As I'm on a Mac, I'll need the binary that's compiled for macOS. In our terminal, we'll download the compressed binary and unzip it, so it's ready for use. I've prepared a basic Promptil configuration file, so let's walk through it. The scrape config block tells Promptil how it should scrape logs from a series of targets using a specified discovery method. If you ever configured Prometheus, this should look pretty familiar. For today, we'll keep it simple and just use a static config which tells Promptil to tilt all the log files that are under varlog on my computer. I've also added a few labels, like the agent label, that we can filter on later. Alright, let's run Promptil with this configuration to see it in action. Notice that we also specified the Loki server URL, so Promptil knows where to ship the logs. We also specify a positions file, which keeps track on how far Promptil has read into a file. Okay, great, Promptil is now running. Let's go to the Grafana Explorer view and see that the logs are sent to Loki by our Promptil agent. Loki is successfully receiving log lines from our agent. Using the log details view, we can now see that our labels are added to every line. Besides Promptil, you can also use the very popular Fluentd data collector. It's written in Ruby and it's a graduated Cloud Native Computing Foundation project. We're gonna create a similar setup with Fluentd as we did with Promptil. The gem command installs the Fluentd Ruby library on our system. To send the logs to Loki, we also need the Loki output plugin for Fluentd. I've prepared a basic Fluentd configuration file. Let's walk through it. In the source section, we specify that we're gonna tail all the files in varlog. In the match section, we configure the Loki plugin. We add a few extra labels, like with Promptil, and we also add a dynamic label that contains the path of the tailed file. Let's run Fluentd with this configuration to see it in action. Great, Fluentd is now running. Let's go to the Grafana Explorer view and see the logs that are sent to Loki by our Fluentd agent. Loki is successfully receiving logs from our Fluentd. In the Fluentd project ecosystem, there is also the Fluentbit agent. It's written in C and that makes it fast and lightweight. We're gonna create a similar setup with Fluentbit as we did with Promptil and Fluentd. I'm on a Mac, so I'll use Homebrew to install Fluentbit. The Loki Fluentbit plugin needs to be compiled from source. We'll clone the Grafana Loki project and run make to compile the plugin. I've prepared a basic configuration file. It's very similar to the Fluentd configuration. Let's walk through it. In the input section, we specify that we're gonna tail all the files in varlog. In the match section, we configure the Loki output plugin. We add a few extra labels, and we also add a dynamic label that contains the path of the tailed file. Let's run Fluentbit with this configuration to see it in action. Great, Fluentbit is now running. Let's go to the Grafana Explorer view and see the logs that are sent to Loki by our Fluentbit agent. Loki is successfully receiving logs from Fluentbit. And we're done! You've now seen the basics of getting data into Loki with Promptil, Fluentd, and Fluentbit. Thank you for watching, see you next time!